ممتاز. جيد، مرحبا لورا وساتشي وكاترينا وسام وكو
مرحبا.
وأنايا وماري وكيلسي وآري وريتشل وأرورا وكيربي وأورينا. ممتاز، أورينا we want to see you and كيربي. ممتاز، مرحبا. I'm so excited. I'm glad you all joined. I'm very happy you are able to.
Thank
All
you.
right, let me show you what I have. Oh, what's that here, Kirby? ما هذا؟ Hums? Bread? Hums? I think you're cutting. you know, do you guys hear what she said? Anybody?
No.
I have no idea what you said. Maybe you can type it in the chat. Moroccan bread. Oh, ممتاز يا كيربي. Can I have some? جيد. Wow, ممتاز. Proud of you. Was it easy to make? كان سهل أو صعب؟ هل سهل أو صعب؟ سهل. صعب. سهل. صعب. سهل. ممتاز. All right. So let me show you what I have. Can you guys see my plate? Okay, maybe here. All right. So I got the celery cut in 2 pieces. I got some rice. It depends. Do you like rice? You can add more. You don't like rice, you can just put a little bit. You don't like it, don't put it. It just depends, whatever you want. And I got parsley and lentils. I like lentils, some, so I put some lentils and some beef in cut into small pieces. I don't know if you can even see it. Very, very small, because we don't really, it's a soup, right? So the beef, it just give it just a little bit of flavor. You don't want too much flavor. You don't want, so if you don't want it, don't put it. But if you have Knorr, which is a flavor for beef, I think I have it somewhere. Ooh. Can you see? Bil Arabi. Oh, Baqar. So, yeah. This is Knorr. If you have Knorr in kitchen, in chicken, in beef, not chicken. This is chicken, but we need beef, right? So, if any kind of, so this is not Knorr, but it's like Knorr. It's Moroccan. If you can see here, man. So either beef flavor or like real beef. Like you can have real beef cut into small pieces. So I hope you have all these ingredients. In terms of the spices, I got some salt. I don't know if you guys can see some salt right here, and some ginger and black olives, not black olives, black pepper. I need some olives, black peppers, right? And paprika and turmeric, yeah? Mumtaz. So those are what I have. You don't wanna put cumin, but you can put these more or less depending. So I hope you have a big pot, because I have a very big pot in here. I don't know if you can see this, but it's big enough for me. I actually bought this from Morocco like 10 years ago, and it's still working fine, strong, going strong. Okay, so I have an onion. I'm gonna cut in 2 pieces. If you have not, do that. So I forgot to do that, so I will do it right now. And I have about 6 or 7 tomatoes. So about 6 medium size. So is there a question? I cannot, who is that? Christine, what you say? I cannot attend anymore.
Sorry, Seth, for one.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah, I got confused between EST and CST time. So
No problem. Shukran.
Have amazing time.
Yeah, we will.
Like the haircut, Sachi. Bye, y'all.
Nasalama. Okay. Measurements for what, yeah, Kirby? You asking for measurements? Okay, ladies. Spices? That's a good question. I never measure. I just use my hand. Okay, let me show you. Maybe let's give you an idea. Where's my camera? Oops.
Okay.
So yeah. Is that helpful, Kirby?
Yes, thank you. Okay.
One test. Awesome. Yes. So like I said, I have not cut the tomatoes, so I will do that. So if you have not, do that also. If you don't cut the onions, we're gonna cut the onions and tomatoes and smash them, grind them, whatever you use. So I'm going to use this. Huh? Oops. Did you say there is not cumin? No cumin. La. All right. So here you go. And this is the machine, right? So you guys have something like this at home, maybe? Awesome. So this is, we're going to grind just the tomatoes and onions, okay? Nothing else. Now, just tomatoes and onions. So I'm going to cry. So if you saw me crying, I'm okay. I'll be okay. Where is the knife? Who has everything ready? Anybody? You do, Katrina? And Sam, who else? Okay, who has the tomatoes and onions ready? Anybody? Mumtaz, that's a hard one because you're gonna cry. Who has all the spices ready? Mumtaz. Who has the celery cut into small pieces? Mumtaz. I see Sam's ready for everything. Okay. Actually, a lot of students are very excited about this, and a lot of them could not make it because of work, and they are doing it. Some of them already did it on the weekend at home and they made video. So I'm gonna share those with you. So they were very excited to try something different. Something they have probably never had. Anybody had Moroccan soup, by the way, harira, anywhere? Anaya, you had it? Tell us your experience. Where, when?
Casablanca. We went to Morocco in like, what year?
Oh, you told me, I forgot. You went to Morocco? Yeah. Yes, I remember that.
2018. I really liked it. The only thing I remember though was that I didn't like the food because there was tomatoes and everything, and I do not like tomatoes.
You don't like tomatoes?
Yeah.
You are weird. Why don't you like tomatoes?
I just don't like it. I don't know. I just don't. Your dad eats them. Yeah, because my dad eats them like crazy.
That's awesome. Did you try any other Moroccan food besides harira, Anaya?
We had the tagine, but I think that was it.
Tagine?
I mean, what else? Oh, we had couscous.
Oh, that's my favorite.
And stuff like that. What else?
We had chicken and we had the squash soup.
Squash soup, yeah.
Is that your mommy?
Yeah, it is my mom.
I say hello. Salam.
Salam alaikum.
Alaikum salam. How are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. Ah, that's awesome. I like it. Tagine also and couscous. Good stuff. All right, so I think I started to cry. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry?
What do you think of my bread? Is it good?
It's so good.
Okay.
So you're just putting it in the oven right now?
No, I'm letting it rise for a second time now.
Can you tell us a little bit, how did you make it so we can learn? Tell us.
Sure. So when I was in Morocco, I got to take a cooking class in Chef Shawin. And it's because, so I sprained my ankle, so I couldn't go on the cool hike that everyone else went on. So my program sent me into a cooking class instead. So that's how I learned how to make Moroccan bread from scratch. And it's really simple. It just takes time. But I have my little notebook from when I was there that tells me the recipe for it. And so they told it to me in grams. So I had to like do the math to convert it to cups today. And I had to half the recipe as well. But it's really simple. So the one that I did today, it's just 3 1/3 cups of wheat flour, a cup of white flour, 10 grams of yeast, and some sugar and salt. And then you mix all the dry ingredients together and then add a little bit of water. Is this showing me on here too? That's weird. Okay, I put it on my phone as well so I could have better connection. So you add water and knead it together little by little, and then divide it up and let it rise for like 15, 20 minutes, and then flatten it out onto a cookie sheet and let it rise again for like an hour. So that's what I'm doing now, is letting it rise again.
Montez. So you made it once before?
So yeah, before? So I made it in Morocco when I took my cooking class, and then I made it another time with my host mom.
Yes.
But then when I came home, like 2 weeks after my trip in Morocco, I tried to make it again and I halved the recipe, but I accidentally, so two things went wrong. One, in Morocco, I used like live yeast. I didn't know that there was a difference between active dry yeast and the yeast that I used while I was there. Mm-hmm. So it didn't rise, first of all. And then secondly, I halved the recipe for everything except for the salt.
Ooh.
So I basically made pretzels when I came back. But that was the one and only time I've tried to make it since then. So hopefully tonight it works out better.
Wow, that's really good. Yeah, so now you had more experience. You made it already 3 times, so I'm sure this time would be better. Inshallah. Any questions? Oh, Jazz. Yeah, bread is very, very important. We eat bread all the time for breakfast, lunch, dinner. Oh, it's crazy. Do you guys eat bread a lot in America? Who loves bread? Tell us. Tell us how do your family deal with bread? Do you eat bread a lot? Aurora, do you guys eat bread a lot at home with your family?
I feel like we do bread like as a side dish when we have soups and stuff, but lots of times when we have bread, it's like to make sandwiches. It's not its own thing, but I ate a lot of bread like for breakfast while I was in Peru, so.
Awesome. So in Peru also eat bread a lot. Okay, anybody else wants to tell us about bread? Who eats bread a lot? Ari, do you guys eat bread a lot at home?
Yeah, we usually make like roti or chapati to eat with curry when we're making bread. Like it's normally to go along with curry or something like that.
Yes. All right. I'm almost done. I know you guys, some of you are done. Some of you are almost done. So I am, as you can see, this is the mixture, the tomato and onions. I'm putting them in the pot. So go ahead and put pretty much everything you have prepared already in the pot. And don't forget to put some oil. Yeah, just a little bit of oil, just like you would put if you cook anything. Not too much, just a little bit. Okay. Right here.
So at this point, we should have our tomatoes, our onions, oil, and what else in our pot?
Yeah, and the spices, if you get them already, and mm-hmm. the pieces of meat, if it's already cut, and yeah, the lentils, like just put everything, the lentils.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm doing that right now too. I'm just trying to finish the last piece of tomato I have, but I'm putting everything right now. Go ahead and put everything.
We put the tomato sauce in too?
I'm sorry?
We put the tomato sauce in too?
Yeah, everything. We're just gonna put everything at the same time. We don't have to start with cooking anything because all the ingredients are pretty much can be cooked at the same temperature, the same time. Just remember, The meat takes longer, but like I said, we cut it into very, very small pieces. So it should be cooked very quickly also. Now I'm putting...
What temperature should we have it at?
You know, Kirby, I don't really go by temperatures and measurements. I just, you know, so maybe you can start with very high, right? And then... But we have to put water. Before you put in the temperature, we're gonna put water, right? We have to add water to it. So.
We put the whole can of tomato paste in, right?
All right, I'm gonna put some more music as we are. Oops.
Girl, yes. Do we put the lemon in now or later?
Lemon? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Until the very end.
Okay.
I'm not gonna put lemon, but since you have it and you wanna do it. After it's almost done, we just squeeze just a little bit, just for to make it a little bit more zitzier, a little bit more, very, very end. Okay.
Okay. Do we put the chickpeas in right now too?
No chickpeas. No. So what I put so far, I had the pot, and I put some oil, and I put the tomato and diced tomato and onions, and I put the celery and. Parsley, cilantro. I put all the spices that I have, and I'm putting water. So be very generous with water because the water is gonna be less anyway. You know, it's gonna be gone with time a little bit. So put enough water. Just put a lot of water, and put it on high. That way it cooks quicker. And yeah, if it's like too liquidy, then we can add at the end some flour to make it a little bit thicker. if we have to. I usually do that without even though I don't need to, because I like mine a bit thick, like it's not just like water. All right, let me.
So do we need to put in 2 or 3 cans of tomato sauce? Because in your video you did 2, but then on the instructions on Blackboard you said 3.
Oops, sorry, I'll do 2.
Okay.
2 of these and 1 of paste, right?
Yes.
Okay. All right.
Can we put the tomato sauce in right now?
Sure, yeah, just put everything except the, what do you call it? The hummus, not hummus, chickpeas, okay? Do you know hummus that you guys buy at Kroger? It's chickpeas in Arabic. So I don't mean to go buy hummus and put it, don't add hummus, the hummus that you eat in the restaurant, don't add it to harira, to the soup, okay? It's just chickpeas.
That Moroccans don't eat chickpeas that often, or they don't use it very often, like traditionally. Didn't you say that Moroccans don't use chickpeas very often? Sorry, no. It's kind of long.
As hummus as the meal,
just like as like an ingredient.
Yeah, we do. We use it with food, like cook with it. Like for example, harira. Did I tell you guys about the cow feet? Delicious. In Morocco, we eat cow feet, y'all, with hummus, with chickpeas. Yeah, we should make that next time.
Can we go ahead and add the meat as well right now, right?
I'm sorry, no?
Do we go ahead and add the meat right now as well?
Not sure, the meat is a really kind of very, very small piece, like really, really tiny.
Okay.
All right, did you all put everything? Make sure it's on high so it's gonna cook quicker. And put some water, enough water, and make sure to mix it and to look at it, you know? We always mix the everything every so often. All right, so how's everybody?
Are we supposed to let it boil?
Yeah, boil. Yeah, of course. Make it high, the highest, and put enough water. I usually put a lot of water, and sometimes if it's too water, like at the end when it's cooked and you feel like it's too liquidy, then we add some flour with it. Like we have maybe about 3 tablespoons of flour, and we mix it with some water. And that flour and water, when you add to it, it makes it thicker. You know what I'm saying? So some people do that, some people don't. I never do it unless it's like too, like I said, too liquidy. Let's see the chat. Is there any more questions here? Okay, yeah, take photos, guys. Mumtaz.
Okay, so when do we put the chickpeas in?
Until the end. The chickpeas, and if you want to add lemon, again, lemon you don't have to, but if you want to add a very, very small amount of squeezing lemon, it's pretty much like 1 minute before it's done or something.
Okay.
And feel free to look at it all the time. If it's coming out, then you want to turn the temperature down, of course. Feel free to taste it. If the, let's say, you want to test some of, especially the lentils and maybe the rice. If you think it's not cooked enough, then you want to keep it longer, things like that. So who has, what are you adding, Laura?
These are my spices. This is coriander, which is just cilantro.
Okay.
Doing it the Arab way and just going through the spice cabinet and adding random things.
Yeah, good. So I have pretty much I put everything already. So all I need is to add later, soon when it's almost done, the chickpeas. Of course, the chickpeas, it's in the can, right? As you can tell, it's already cooked. It's going to be easy to cook. The last thing we can add. And what else? And that's it. That's all I'm adding. Again, I might add some flour with it if I need to, but I do not care much about the lemon. But if you do have lemon and you want it to be lemony, zitsy, then you can just add just a little bit according to your taste. How are you doing, Cole? I see you. You look like you're done. You're done, Cole? No?
I got all the ingredients in. I was just sniffing
with a few minutes. Very good, Cole. Very good. How about you, Orina? You look like you're done also?
Yeah, I'm just letting it cook.
Oh, okay. So you just have the chickpeas left, right?
Yeah.
Awesome. Who else? I have not. Oh, Katrina, how's it going? Almost done?
It's going good. I'm trying to keep it from spilling out of the pot. I don't think I used a big enough one, but it's fine.
Yeah, that's something very important. You guys want to keep looking at it. And again, if it starts to boil too much and start to be out of control, you just want to turn the temperature down and should be fine. You can always add more water if you need to. If you think you don't have enough water, you can still add water, no problem. Sam, I see you're concentrating.
He's looking tremendous right now.
Tremendous? Oh, great. How about you, Kelsey? How's it going? Almost done?
What? It's popping everywhere. Take it a minute.
Good. Okay. Sachi, did you go to... There you go, Sachi. I thought you left us.
Barhaba.
I thought you started eating early.
No, not yet.
So is it good? Everything's good, Sachi?
Yeah, everything's in there. Just making sure it doesn't spill.
No, yeah, that's very important. Mary. Anna, Mary, how's it going?
It's going good.
I see you got some help there.
My family's helping me.
Barhaba. That's awesome. That's awesome. Okay, who else? I have not. How's it going, Anya? Almost done, Anya?
Yeah, I got it. It's just sitting there and it's just boiling now.
Boiling? That's a good sign. Boiling is good. So it's almost, we might be finishing in the next probably 15 minutes and should be done if you guys have already started like putting everything and you're done. Ari. How's it going, Ari? Are you doing okay?
Yeah, it's going good. I have my computer away.
You like it? Did you test it already?
Hmm?
Did you test it?
Oh, not yet. No, it's still on the stove.
But you can tell the smell, right?
Yeah, it smells really good.
Oh, great. Great. Fantastic. I hate it, man, to that Abba Hansa. Oops. Aurora, I see you there, bored. Are you done?
I'm just letting it heat up some. I think that my burners are a little bit weak. I don't know what's going on with them because it won't. They're as high as they go.
Okay, that's fine. That's sometimes it's actually better to cook slow, but I usually do the highest and then I lower it to medium and then when it's done to low. And when I put it on low, that's when I add I call it hummus, but I'm not talking about the food that you guys eat. I'm talking about chickpeas. Chickpeas in Arabic is hummus. And the lemon if you want to. Rachel, كيف الحال? Almost done. You are just waiting for it also.
Mine is also not boiling yet, even though it's on the highest setting, so I think I still have a little bit to go.
Okay, well, bring some wood and put some wood and some fire around it. That's good.
No.
Yeah, don't do that. Awesome. Well, let's take a group photo, guys, so we can remember those things. Let's all be in the picture. Group photo. All right, you guys ready? Everybody's here. Smile. Oh, we did good. You guys can unsmile.
Okay, guys, here's my bread.
Oh, let me
it's
see.
It's risen.
Ooh, so, it looks like pita bread.
So I'm going to put it in the oven now.
Oh, okay. I thought it's cooked. So it's going to get you.
No, this is it after it's risen.
Yeah, it looks good. Hey, what kind of flour did you use?
I used, it was like 3/4 wheat flour, 1/4 white flour.
You mixed them? Good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's good. Then as it's starting to finish, we can taste it, of course. You can add some salt if you want to. If it's too salty, sorry. No, you can add probably some water. If you wanna add some, if you like peppers, maybe you can add some more if you want to. So I always add peppers and salt a little bit at the end. It's easy and it's safe to add anytime really. Versus the other like turmeric, or those need time to dissolve and to mix with everything. Oh, you know what? I forgot to add my cow, not the whole cow, just the cow flavor. But I should be okay. I'm not gonna add it because I already have some meat, so I don't. It's fine. So we don't have to have that. Who has made soup before, any kind of soup? Because that's the only soup I know. Oh, look at you. Which one, Laura?
Like soups in general or like Arab soups?
The one that you made.
Okay. I've made butternut squash soup at Gatton, and it was like a curry.
Ooh.
And I made like lentil soup and like just different kinds. Minestrone.
You're gonna do well on the harira soup because you have experience.
I hope so.
Who else made soup before? Because soups can be tricky. I'm always afraid of making soups. This is the only one I know, actually. Rachel, share with us.
Last year, or I think it was 2 years ago, actually, we grew pumpkins in my grandma's garden, and we made pumpkin soup for Thanksgiving. And it took a really long time because we had to boil down the pumpkins, but I thought it was really good.
Oh, mumtaz, jayi jiddan. Mumtaz, anybody else? Anybody made any kind of soup? Oh, Kirby, tell us. Another Moroccan soup? No.
No, so I made a vegan butternut squash soup. It was pretty good. And then a like chicken noodle soup, but it was with chickpeas. Mm. I think it was also vegan.
Yes. Wow, that's awesome. That's great. Anybody else? How about the boys? Nothing? Oh, Aurora, tell us.
I've made like chicken soup and potato soup before, so.
Oh, is it two different things or potato and?
Yeah, different things.
Oh, nice.
It's just kind of like you take your ingredients and some chicken stock and you just throw them in a pot and it's like, it's fine. Yeah. So.
Well, definitely try. I will try to cook some more this winter break. Maybe I can succeed doing something different. Yeah, I'm always afraid of making soups because soups can be tricky. Anybody else? Oh, Jazz. How about any kind of Arabic food? Maybe falafel, or you guys tried hummus before you made it, or baba ghanoush, or any kind of Arabic food that you guys probably try to make. Katrina, what did you make?
I made falafel and hummus before.
Oh, at home or in school?
At home.
That's awesome. And how were you inspired to make them? Did you just hear about them, or you ate them somewhere and you liked them? And
well, I'm vegan actually, so a lot of food that typically Americans eat, like, it's hard to make it vegan. And so those were two things that I've had before that I really liked, so they're easy to make vegan, so we just made them.
Yes, I love falafel. Maybe one time we can make falafel. It's easy. Last semester, you guys remember, we had the food collaboration day with the Department of Tourism and Hospitality Management. You remember the hotel studies, I guess? And remember Rachel and Sachi, right? We cooked in the big kitchen. We made falafel. What else? Hummus, right?
And I think we had baba ghanoush.
Baba ghanoush, yes.
And oh, tagine too.
Yes, tagine, yes.
We made falafel yesterday, so I have like a huge bag of falafel.
Oh my goodness. Send that over to us through Zoom.
Yeah, I'll mail it to everyone.
Did you make it by yourself, Laura, or your parents helped, your mom helped you?
My dad is the falafel person. So usually I help him, but I was busy yesterday.
So your dad makes falafel? Mm-hmm. That's awesome. Yeah. Usually Arab dads don't get close to the kitchen.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Make falafel because it's like a street food. So, one more time, Laura.
But we got a recipe. Oh, it's like a street food, so people usually don't make it like themselves. Yeah, yeah. But we've been venturing to.
Right, yeah. I like to cook, but I'm not very good. So I just know a couple of things and I can just keep doing the same thing. but I think I need to learn more. How about you, Orina? Tell us, are you a good cook?
No.
Nothing?
Not good at it. I don't do it too often.
Oh, okay. You just eat?
Yeah. Preferably.
Exactly. That's the best thing to do. Just eat.
Yeah.
Sam must be a good cook because he was ready. He got everything ready before us. And right, Sam? Do you cook often?
No, I don't cook at all, actually.
This really?
No.
Well, I'm proud of you because when we started, you got everything ready.
That was maybe my mom.
Your mom helped you?
Cut up everything.
Okay, good. It's okay because it's a lot. I'm gonna go check in mine because I forgot myself. The last thing, hummus, but I'm not gonna add it right now. So just one can of hummus. That's all we have to have. That's all we have to add soon. Anybody thinks the soup is ready? Anybody maybe tasted it yet? Or who has cooked probably first?
I think that we're done. We've tasted it now. It tastes really good. Good. I like it.
You like it? Oh, proud of you.
Yeah. Can we add the chickpeas now, or should we save that to like we're serving it?
So you tried it and you think it's done, like the rice, the lentils, the beef, everything?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, if it's all done, then go ahead and add chickpeas, yeah.
Okay.
And even you can add some of the lime that you have if you want to, just a little bit. you can taste it, and if you want more, you can add more. You can always add, right? How about you, Kelsey? Namia, Rachel?
Do you recommend that we drain the chickpeas, or do we leave the...
Yeah, because it has water, right? Yeah, just drain it, and that's it. You don't have to wash it, just drain it. Yes. Good question. Are you going to add it right now, Rachel? You think you're almost done?
I think mine still needs a little bit. I put mine on, like, I don't know, maybe like 5 minutes after you, so I'm going to wait a little.
Wait, yeah, just wait, because chickpeas are ready, like, they are already, because they are in the water for, like, how many years?
No.
So they are going to be really easy, just maybe the last 2 minutes, 3 minutes. Yeah, because if you put them way early, the chickpeas would just dissolve completely.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
I did my chickpeas. I have like dried ones, and yep. So I put the I looked at a few different recipes before tonight so I could be prepared, because I made mine like without meat and stuff. But I Yeah, so I put my chickpeas in at the beginning because they're dry.
Oh, that's
actually, not from the can.
That's actually a lot of people in Morocco, they do that, actually. That's the original recipe, because cans and tomatoes in cans, all those things are new.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's what people do, actually. But for us, it's just easier. It's ready. And mm-hmm. I did it. And I don't really see a big difference, but I think that would be, this is the right way, Kirby. Good job. All right, anybody else who's almost done? Kelsey, are you almost done, Kelsey? I think Kelsey's frozen.
Yeah, I think mine's done.
Did you try it?
No, it's a lot.
Try it and let us know. Maybe you can adjust the salt, maybe, or pepper, or what? Is it too thick, or what do you think?
I mean, it looks like.
Looks like soup, okay. If it looks like soup,
like that's consistency, you know.
Okay. That's good.
Yeah.
Well, when you test it, let us know. Did you add chickpeas already?
Yeah.
You did? Okay. Well, test it, and I'm curious.
Okay.
Yes. Yes. So how is it, Anya? I see you testing right now.
I really like it. I told you before, I don't like tomatoes, but it's really good. Wow. It's like very hearty. I like it. I'm a big soup person, so I really like this.
Perfect. Wow. That's great. Glad you have it. Anya, do you guys eat dates?
Yeah, all the time.
Do you like dates?
Yeah.
We'll try it with dates, probably. Some people do that in Ramadan.
Mm-hmm.
You might like it with dates. I don't know.
Mom brought home a bunch of food yesterday. Like, she brought home lentil soup, falafel, like shawarma. Like, they had a big order, and she brought all of it home. So we've just, like, been eating that for 2 days. Like, I've only been eating lentil soup for 2 days. So I'm glad that I have something new to try now.
Yeah, something different, right? Something new.
Yeah. These are the kinds that we eat at the house. I don't know if...
What's that?
This is just the kind that we get. We always... Sokri. Whenever we go to
Is that
Saudi Arabia. Yeah, we always just bring those.
These are good. It has.
Like the chocolate covered ones.
Yeah.
Those are really good.
Great. Right? Yeah, I just tried mine, and it feels like it needed some more salt. So I added some salt, and actually added some water, because it's still a little bit like the celery. I didn't feel like it's well cooked, so it needs more time. So mine is still high, and added some water and some more salt. So make sure to try yours and see what you would need to, if you need to add. Mary, are you eating the soup or drinking the soup?
I'm eating it.
What, you are right now?
Yeah.
You're done?
I have my soup cooked off.
So it's done, right?
Mm-hmm.
So how is it?
It's really good.
Oh my god, that's the first time you make it. Good job. Wow. Anybody else? Almost done.
I'm pouring it out right now, and you can get a taste test from me and my mom.
Are you tasting right now? Hi, mom.
I love this class.
Oh.
Make them cook.
You should join us. So tell us how it tastes. Hopefully it's good. If it's good,
I'm sure it looks good.
If it's not good, it's
not. Rihta tayyiba.
Rihta tayyiba? Hello, hello. Kwaisa?
Kteer tayyiba. Ladida? لذيذة جدا.
أوه.
الحساء بتقول له حساء ولا شوربة؟
حساء بس بالمغربي الحريرة.
حريرة. كتير طيبة. شكرا.
حريرة. هي حريرة أيضا كلمة عربية.
حريرة.
ولكن نقول خصوصا هذا النوع من الحساء أو الحساء نقول له حريرة نسميه بالحريرة. نعم. أو بالأحرى الحريرة الحامضة أو الحامضة لأنها هناك طماطم كثيرة وربما بعض الناس يضيفون الحامض فتسمى بالحريرة الحامضة.
نحن نعمل في سوريا حساء عدس الحامض بيعملوا بس الدارك لنتلز بيحطوا له ليمون جوس وسبينتش
فينيش كمان حلو ممتاز.
This is delicious. بس الحامض comes from tomatoes من البندورة right؟
البندورة وفي ناس كمان بيحطوا حامض من الحامض أو اللايم حتى.
بتحطوا شيء حر لحتى بيسموها حريرة؟
كيف؟
Is there anything spicy حر؟
Spicy not really. Maybe the peppers that the only spicy I think we add. We have in Harira, but nothing spicy. But the hamid or the lime, we call it the lemon or the hamid. Maybe some people add just a little bit of the hamid in the end. Very good. It's a good
one.
It's a good one. It's a good one. It's a good Good job, Laura. Laura, she did awesome because her mom liked her soup. So congratulations to Laura. We're married.
Thank you.
And Rachel, too. Did you try it, Rachel?
Yeah, I tried it. I ended up adding some more salt. So
I did too. I don't put a lot of salt at the beginning, but because you can always add it at the end. So how is the thickness of it? Is it like... It's perfect or too thick or
mine is pretty thin, but I really like thin soup, so I think I'll skip on the flour.
Yeah. Good. Mumtaz. Kelsey, it seems like you're done too, right?
I'm eating it. That's good.
Show us.
I didn't put the beef in because I don't eat meat, so.
Oh, that's fine. Yeah, you just want the flavor. Yeah, of course. Did you test it? Is it good?
Oh yeah, it's really good. I actually put sugar in there at the beginning because my tomatoes were pretty bitter. I tried them.
Ah, you had sugar. That's awesome. You should like it. And it's
Yeah, good. Just a little bit, like
mm-hmm.
Cut out the bitterness.
That's awesome. Almost done. Sam, tell us about your experience.
Honestly, it's pretty good.
Yeah? Okay.
I didn't know about those chickpeas, but they're not bad.
Have you added chickpeas, Sam?
Yeah.
So you like them? You usually don't eat chickpeas? Is that what you said?
Never had them before.
Never had them before? Wow. That's awesome. But have you cooked a soup before, Sam?
Can't say I have. I've watched people cook soup.
Yeah. Are you on campus or are you with your family?
I'm back home.
That's awesome. So your parents would be proud of you, Sam. Yeah. I saw Kirby. I saw you put a picture of Harira. That means you are done, Kirby?
Mom. And my bread.
Oh, your bread too? Wow. Mm-hmm.
That's really good.
Wow. The color of Harira is beautiful. Is it too thick? Too thick?
Not for me. I like it. This
way. That way? Okay.
Yeah.
It just depends. Like, you don't have to, it is not like right or wrong. It just depends. If you like it thick, it's fine. I don't like mine thick very much. So that's why I asked if you want to add more, maybe water. Ari, I see you're eating it too.
Yeah, it's really good.
Wow. You guys are so good. You guys followed the directions and you did awesome, even though there's no measurements, really. You just like... Oh, the brother likes you too, right, Mary? Tell us, what's your name?
He got a clean bowl. His name's Nolan.
I'm sorry?
Nolan.
Nolan. Beautiful name, Lauren. Nolan. You like it, Nolan?
He really likes it.
That's awesome. Enjoy. Do you guys know how to say enjoy in Arabic? Let me write it for you in the chat. Let me just one second. I'm going to change the language. Okay. So, where is here? It's bissaha. I just sent it to Christine by herself. Oops, she's not even here. To everyone. Okay. So, do you guys see it? Can you guys read it? All right. Who can read it for us loud and proud?
Bissaha.
Mumtaz. Yeah. Bissaha, it really translates to, what do you guys, if you think about bissaha, what word that comes to your mind? Bissaha. Huh? Naam?
With health.
Health, right? Saha is health, but what's the other word that comes? What's right and wrong? Bismillah. No. Bissaha. Remember sahih? What's sahih? Sahih?
Like right?
Right, yeah, correct. Right, yeah. But it's really comes from health, not right, but it's kind of close. Sahih is right, yeah. So bisaha is really with health, yeah. Cheers. We're going to wait a couple more minutes till everybody is done and we can take a picture of the soup, maybe together with the soup. Make sure you leave some, guys. Don't eat all of it.
Do you guys want to see my dog and his Christmas sweater?
Of course. Let's see. Oh my goodness, so cute.
Jin-Gin. We put it on him today.
Oh, he's warm.
Sweater, I know that my dogs would hate it.
What, this sweater? Is it too hot for him? Yeah, we'll turn the AC on.
He's loving it.
Aurora, I have an idea for you, Aurora. Turn the AC on, turn to 50 degrees, and he will wear it.
My dogs are big and fuzzy, so they already have big coats, basically, and so they would hate a sweater.
Okay. Spoiled dog. Approved. He likes it. Proud of you. Who else has just tried it? I guess just me and Rachel, right? Is Sachi done? Oh, you're done, Sachi?
Yes, I just finished.
Oh, you finished?
I also just finished.
No, I'm cooking.
Okay, so you're trying right now?
Yes.
Is it good, Sachi? Is it good?
Yes. I don't really like tomatoes either, like Anaya, but I like it.
Oh, Montez. And Rachel is almost done too. Okay. I think I'm almost done too.
I'm pouring my bowl now, so I'm about to try.
I'm sorry? My soup is looking scrumptious. Very scrumptious, right, Orina? As scrumptious as Orina's.
Indeed.
My parents said it is very good. Oh, who's this? Ari, glad your parents like it. Oh my goodness, that's awesome. So this, let's make this a tradition, guys. And every Thanksgiving, you guys make this at home for your parents. So your parents will make you the turkey and you guys make them the harira soup. Okay, who else? How about Cole? I think Cole has already tried it, right, Cole? Tell us, Cole, you already tried it, right?
Yeah, it's good. I'm a big fan of it. I gave some to my parents just now. They seemed to like it.
You're a big fan. That's awesome. I'm a big fan of also. Who else?
I like it. I just tried it and my sisters seem to like it too. So.
Oh, glad to hear that. That's awesome. Wow. Good job, guys. You guys follow directions and you guys are just good at anything you do. I mean, this is the first time. That's great. I'm just waiting for Rachel. I think mine is almost done too. So I'm gonna put it on the bowl and all of you put like a bowl of it and let's hold it and let's take a picture of it. Okay, so everybody have some harira in the bowl. Everybody, you can see the smoke. It's magical. All right, so Ari, we cannot see your harira. Rachel, we cannot see your harira. And who else? And Anaya, we cannot see your harira. So you guys ready? Oops, not yet. What am I doing? Okay, sorry. So I'm gonna take it in a, I'm gonna say 1, 2, 3, okay? So 1, 2, and when I say 3, you guys don't move, keep, because it's tricky to take a picture. So 1, 2, 3. I was not smiling. Let's repeat one more time. I was looking at the camera and I was concentrating, so I did not smile. Okay, let me see. Okay, so واحد, اثنان, ثلاثة. I was not smiling either. What's wrong with me? I cannot even smile anymore. Okay, واحد, اثنان. What? What's wrong with me? Okay, I'm gonna be smiling the whole time. Oh, you know what happens? It brings me to the same picture that I took at the beginning. So I have to get rid of it first, or save it. And then I'm gonna be able to take a picture. What's wrong? Sorry guys. Just one more try, okay? I promise, it's gonna be the last one, okay? Okay, so واحد, اثنان, ثلاثة. Oh, this is beautiful. Woo. All right, so make sure I save this one because it's the best. Okay. Good job, y'all. Let me look one more time. Oops. Well, it's somewhere, but it's good. Good job, guys. So everybody's done? Rachel? Oops. Rachel. I want to hear your opinion, Rachel. Is it good?
No. I like it.
Ladida. Ooh, ladida, delicious. Ladida. Ladida jidda. Okay, did I ask everybody? Okay, I think I talked to everybody. You all done? Everybody's done. You guys, I'm glad we did this. It's fun. We have one more club activity next week, which is gonna be Arbash, which is Arabic and English. It's like a separate club where we just converse. So we practice Arabic. It's gonna be a great opportunity to also practice for the test and bring questions. And so make sure to join us with our last activity. Do you guys have any question at all? Any questions? هل عندكم سؤال؟ سؤال؟ جواب؟ Answers? No? Okay. Well, I'm still going to be around here for the next 15 minutes. Enjoy my harira. If you guys want to still chat with me, if you want to drink harira together, you can stay. If you have to leave, you can leave. But shukran, shukran. Ooh. Mmm. Ladida. لذيذة جدا.
شكرا و سعيد عيد الشكر.
عيد شكر سعيد يا. Gracias.
مع السلامة.
عيد تكسيفين سعيد. مع السلامة شكرا.